My name is Vera Luisa Franco. I am a possibility management trainer and coach, and I am a possibilitator. And I'm serving right now for this time as the main space holder of the possibilitator training with a team. And as I'm welcoming everybody to come in, I'm just so glad to see, you know, I'm so glad that the squares on my computer keep getting smaller and smaller, because it means that there's so many people attending this call. And so I have like a maximum of 49 in one screen. And so it's getting to the full screen right now. And I'm glad that so many of you are interested in transformation. The possibility, so I'd like to if you have a hands up if you read the website. You're gonna have a hands up if you read the website before coming here. Okay, so a few yes, a few no. Thank you. The possibilitator training is an emerging Gaian game world that basically is an international community of practice, an international village of people who are committed to themselves, their growth, to take radical responsibility, so that a next culture, Archearchy, next culture meaning Archearchy, which is the collaboration between the archetypally initiated feminine collaborating with the archetypally initiated masculine, so that this culture, the Archearchy culture, can emerge. And it will emerge when enough people are taking a stand for it to come. And this village, this international village, is a community of practice. And it took so these many years for it to exist. The possibility management exists for quite a long time. And so far, some game worlds have existed, people have done multiple like possibility teams that got together in so many different configurations, but it so far no globally connected game world has been created so that we can practice together, can research together. And so the possibilitator training is attempting to do this. It's really for you, if you are interested in doing this transformation and in your own growth, and you're taking a stand for your own development, for your own growth, then you have such commitment to it that you want to be in a team of highly committed people too. I came to possibility management in 2016. And I used to live in the eco village and spiritual community in Scotland, in northeast of Scotland, called Finhorn. And it was actually through friends of mine from Finhorn who had done an expand the box training with Clinton, that I saw their transformation. I saw their you know, I had been in Finhorn for almost 8 years. And it took a long time for people to transform. And what I saw was some of my friends that came back completely changed just from a month being away. And this got me thinking, well, what could make such effective and quick transformation? I was hooked. I just really wanted to know what this was about. And so in 2016, I did my first Expand the Box and in Mallorca with Clinton, and some things I just had the sense that I already knew. They seemed like this, of course this is like this. Of course this is, why isn't there more trainings that do exactly this thing of upgrading our thoughtware, of really that try to answer the question or try to create this path about what is it that I'm here to do? This is, was my most important question. What is my archetypal lineage? And I remember so clearly when Clinton, and I think in the first day of the Expand the Box, says this sentence that my mind had no idea what he was talking about, but it totally resonated in all of my bodies. And it was something like this: when an initiated adult man places his attention on initiated adult woman, she automatically wakes up and remembers the way to the center of the great labyrinth of spaces and can take the man there. And so this, for my head, sounded like a riddle, like, what is this? But for my, all of my bodies, it was, there was this huge screaming of, yes, I don't know what he's talking about, and I know what he's talking about. This, and the, when Clinton said also in the same day about jacking into the archetypal lineage, it was crazy. It was, you know, there's a difference between reading a book from someone who's been to the Himalayas and he's describing things, and another thing, or watching a documentary about it. And another thing is having a conversation with someone who's just been in the Himalayas. The energy is totally different. And so this is what it felt like for me when I was in the Expand the Box training, and Clinton was speaking to me with this most important question that I had about archetypal lineage from lived experience of being there. This is what really felt. And so I knew in that first day that I was a possibilitator, that I was a possibility manager, and I just wanted to be part of this. I wanted to be holding spaces so that other people could transform. This for me was the beginning of a beautiful path until now. And I'm so excited because throughout my time in possibility management, I became a trainer, an Expand the Box trainer, and a lab trainer. And I saw so that most people would just go to an Expand the Box, and maybe they would do a lab, and maybe they would go for a year, 2 years without doing any labs. And maybe they would go to a possibility team, and maybe not so frequently. And this community feeling was missing. And it wasn't until Anne-Chloe Destremaux created an international community of trainers that I started really realizing, gosh, we need it. Like, this is what, for me, a true community is. It's not just people together for the sake of being together. They're together to research, to practice in the same context, in the same purpose. And there was only a path for maybe for trainers. Where were the other space holders? And so the legend tells that Clinton responded, Clinton's archetypal lineage responded to a particular need of one person in New Zealand who basically said, well, if not on the trainer path, wait, Clinton is saying, yes, you go ahead.
Jay, can I use your name?
Yes, you can.
This is Jay Horton. And I was having this intense conversation with Jay, and he said, if I am not getting to be in this, what can I be in? And that hit me so deeply that I couldn't hardly sleep that night. And it was like, there is an opportunity here that has not been possible. I started in possibility management in 1975. Okay, that was when I first became a possibilitator. It was 1975. And then the game world itself evolved very slowly until 1998. And then it started to evolve quicker at the first Expand the Box training. And since the 2000, whatever, 5, 10, 15, it's been evolving more on its own, really by its own intelligence, under the influence of, I don't know what, like what's needed. But we have never had a global tribe of possibilitators who were committed to this actually as a path. And, you know, I've said that it's a path and people have told us it's a path, but we didn't realize the value of the mountain climbing team. And when Jay said that, what can I be in then? He essentially in that moment invented the Possibilitator tribe. And so I'm just forever grateful for the radical honesty from Jay's sharing and that I could hear it and the vulnerability of our conversation, because out of that emerged this whole field right now. And I just, while I'm speaking, I just want to share the thing that really excites me almost most about this is that we've been talking about possibility management is thoughtware for next culture. Possibility management is thoughtware for archearchy, the next culture. And we also knew that almost everything from modern culture needs to be reinvented, in taken out of the hierarchy, put into circles, taken out of a profit motive, put into an initiation-centered culture, taken out of for a distant authority and relocalizing authority and all of that. And it's so the application, the way that it will work is that in possibilitator training, you will discover your piece of the puzzle. Each one of you has your gifts to bring to building out next culture. And we don't know what your piece of the puzzle is. And you can find, we're gonna help each other find that. What is your piece of the puzzle that you're gonna, that you can bring to contribute to and build out so other people can inhabit what you build. You're going to build out the game world part of next culture and other people will get to be with you in that. And this to me is the most exciting thing because I don't know what the specialties will be. I mean, I know that there's going to be whole permaculture because right now there's lots of permaculture, but it's all external permaculture. It's all about seed saving and soil development. And we've got that part. I mean, this part is working. What we don't have is the inner permaculture that goes with it. And so if you don't have the inner permaculture with the outer permaculture, you need whole permaculture. So you need both parts. So I know this whole place needs to be invented. And I know that there's these, education is not working. Education is based on 100 years ago or 200 years ago, and it's feeding people into the corporate system. It's not working. So whole new systems of child raising and education and development need to be created. And there's, you know, there's these refugee camps. And right now refugee camps are set up as, we're a bunch of victims, please give us, you know, please save us. And really a refugee camp is a nano nation. It's the seed of a nano nation. All that group of people needs is the thoughtware. You put the thoughtware and this people together and you have a next culture nano nation called new refugees. And the thing is, we are just as much refugees from modern culture as anybody who's had to leave their country because of a war or a famine or climate change. Anybody who's hit the road, we also have hit the road because of evolution, because we've evolved beyond the thought limits of modern culture. We are refugees. So the new refugees is a specialty, and I don't know what the rest of the specialties are, but I'm just so excited that we get to work together to empower each other to build out this infrastructure for next culture. And thank you, Jay.
Yes. So how, you know, that this game world is in development, it's going to be in evolution. And what we got is that how it works is that the people in the Possibilitator training would be committed to attending, to participating in 5 expand the box trainings and 10 possibility labs, so that they go through the basic core initiations, enough core initiations, so that they're enough stabilized in the adult ego state so that they can be their they can deliver the tasks and the jobs and the clarity of their bright principles and distill what is their speciality. And sometimes like what Clinton said, there are some specialities that we know, and maybe you'll discover a speciality that is needing emerging, but that doesn't exist just yet. So this might be you, this might be your path. And also in the practical ways of how it works is there's already clumps, there's already regions, there's already groups of people that are going to meet regularly, weekly. And each of these groups that are meeting weekly, they'll have weekly calls. And you know, when the pandemic crisis is over, then the meetings will not be all online, will be in physical presence. But for each of these groups that have regular weekly calls, there will be one space holder. And we have already some space holders in the call right now. And I'd like to have a show of hands of if you are a space holder for the Possibilitator training groups, please put your hand up. Thank you. And I would like to hear you. I would like to invite you to welcome yourselves so that people here can know who you are, how you got into possibility management, and what turns you on and being a space holder in the Possibilitator training.
Hi, I'm Patricio. I come from Spain, but I live in New York City. And I got into possibility management. I think I went to the Intimacy Journey workshop with Georg Pollitt, and I remember that after 2 days with him, I told him, you know, I want what you have. Mm-hmm. You know, I just tell me how to get it, and I said, well, just do it, expand the box training, and yes. And also I did my first expand the box training with Clinton, and the third day I almost left. And I was so scared and so blown away by the whole thing. And I had a little bit experience that Vera had. It's just like I was listening something that was resonating all over my body and all my bodies, and at the same time I didn't understand anything. And I say this because part of being in a space holder for me is like doing an impossible job. Mm. You know, it's just like I cannot not do it. It's like and I'm fighting against it, and I do emotional healing processes like why am I doing this? and this is the question that I have. It's like I don't want to. I don't want to do this, and at the same time, is like I cannot not do it. And this is like every this is like an everyday reality for me. Like, what does it mean to be a space holder? What does it mean to marry my life with being a refugee, really, and the is being a space holder for me is this continuous movement out of modern culture that really is inside of me. So, yeah, and I'm excited about this because I'm a possibilitator, and you know, part of my life is living in a world of with no words. So in the world of music and in the world of communicating in that arena. So I'm very excited also to discover my own specialty besides being an ETB trainer and a lab trainer. Yeah. Thank you and welcome everyone.
Thank you, Patricio. Who is the next space holder?
Me. Hello. Hello, everyone. I'm Joana Cruz. I live in Portugal. I am Portuguese. Or my box, it's part Portuguese. I have my first contact with Possibility Manage was in a cafe. I met a friend for exchanging books, and he brought the book from Clinton. And I was just reading the book and I saw old map of feelings, new map of feelings. And I had no map of feelings. So I was completely without any emotional language. My system was running and making choices and going through life just with the unconscious, basically. And I felt so much joy to have like clarity with so simple like pages. And I was like, can I take this book home? Like, of course. And this book is from Vanda. So Vanda is the responsible to have brought Clinton to Portugal. And Clinton came for the first expander box. And when Vanda said like, hey, do you want to go for ETB, for expand the box training with Clinton. And it's about the book, it's about practicing the book. And I was like, of course, because how is this guy doing this like experiential? So I come from the healthcare system. I'm a physiotherapist, osteopath. I always worked a lot with the body. And through osteopathy, I had some glimpse of how emotion can be somatized in the body. So I was very, very curious about this topic myself, even for my life story. So it was such a great experience. I was completely blown away with distinction, with the responsible map. So telling the story of my life that I thought I was a victim and to discover why exactly that happened to me, how I made that happen. I was like, wow, like, yeah, I want to continue to do this for myself. So this was like this for years. I wanted to work on myself, discover more about myself until Vanda no longer, she wanted to write her books and she wanted to do something else. And she invited me to organize ETBs. And then I said, no, thank you. I'm fine. I'm okay. I just want to do this for myself. And until I like 3 days after, I said, okay, expand the box. This is really expanding my box. And this is coming to me. So I guess the greatest things in my life came to be by invitation, kind of. And then I said, yes, just please tell me everything. I didn't even know the word logistics before. So if you enter into this world, you're gonna know what's logistics. So yeah, and it was great. Slow process of talking to people, like one by one. We were having a meeting today in the morning. I was like, yeah, this has been a slow process until I met Vera almost 3 years ago in Costa Rica. And I guess that was the first step towards my training. Yes. So I had the train a yes to become a trainer. So I never met Vera before. She's Portuguese too, in possibility management world, discovering the world, and we've met and we deliver a workshop and in initiatory adulthood for regenerative culture in Envision Festival at Costa Rica. It was a great initiation, my first time on stage, like holding space for such extraordinary space. And since then, after Anne Chloe also creating this online international amazing space, it was kind of a boom and a field of going further and further into thriving into responsible spaces, to be responsible for a space to hold that. And I really, I didn't know that about myself, that I really Joanna, thrive on responsibility.
And Joanna, you're the space holder for the Portuguese region.
Yes, and yes, I am.
Patricio, you're space holder for?
Yes, and I'm the space holder for the Americas right now. I mean, for North America.
North America, yeah.
Yes, North America.
Cool. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Joanna.
Thank you.
Okay. And I invite you to New Zealand. My name is Julia Neumann, and that's not a Kiwi name. I came here from Germany about 4 years ago, and I had come across possibility management through mysterious ways. My sister said, lived in Munich at the time, and in 2015, and she said, hey, there's this weird thing, but it sounds really interesting. It's called Fear on the Mountain. It was a day workshop with Michael Hallinger. And I thought, okay, let's do that. And so for one day we did this hike in a mountain area in southern Germany, and it was all about fear, feeling fear as we walked, and I was invited to listen with my feet. And it's like, how does that go? And feeling the fear from my feet. And it was just really a total new experience in my whole body. And I could sense the energies of dark places and how it feel really low intensities of fear. I could feel my fear now actually as well. And that's so cool. It's like, okay, I'm alive. And when we came down from this mountain, it's like, okay, where do I find out more about this? And there weren't so many trainings at the time in Germany, but there was this book as well. So here's the book again. And I bought Clinton's book. It's like Directing the Power of Conscious Feelings. And I read it in that summer and signed up for the ETB that happened in November that year. And that was it. I also, similar to Vera, I knew really quickly, it's like, okay, this is what I want to do. I want to, like, this is, it was just so new and so radical and clear. And like when I think back at like this term refugee, from it really resonates with me, because I think from when I was really little, I was thinking there must be something different possible, because this doesn't seem right. Something's not right here. And it was really a gift for me to notice, okay, there's others that have figured this out or are on the journey of creating something different. So then, the whole trainings that I went to just opened up the door for me to come to New Zealand. And when I decided to come and live in New Zealand, it was clear I don't want to stop this body of work. I want to keep going. And so Georg Pollitt, whom Patricio mentioned earlier, and I were sitting in a possibility lab together when he said, Julia, if you're going to New Zealand and you want possibility management there, know that I'm willing to come and deliver trainings there. And so that's what eventually happened. He started us off on trainings, and I started and found Ana Norambuena, who is here as well as a space holder. And she and I just created the first training, we organized the first trainings together. And now she's a possibility lab trainer, and her and I are holding Expand the Box trainings here in New Zealand. And yeah, that's a gift. So I'm really grateful. And I want to add actually that the first lab I went to, I came out of and was like, this is so great. How can I keep connected with these people? How can I stay connected? And I was trying to create this platform, this online platform that we could elaborate on and so on. And I'm noticing that this is actually it. You know, this is what I was wanting after my first lab. So thank you for creating this and being here.
Thank you, Julia. Julia, hey. Next, space. Sofia Magdalena.
Yes.
Next. Thank you.
My name is Sofia Magdalena, and I'm the space holder for the region of Germany. And I met possibility management some years ago, in which my partner went to an expand the box training because the face of his cousin has changed. And he was like, he told her, something with your face happened. I want to do whatever you did for your face changed, because you got this, I don't know how it is called, but
wrinkles
in your face. And in Chinese medicine, they say you found your life's path. So I want to go whatever you did. And so he went to the expand the box training. And
these are these red blood cells, the red, you know, it's when you scream so loud, the blood vessels break. That's what it is. You found your life path. This is cool. Thank you.
You're welcome. And I was just in my place in France where I lived that time, and I freaked out. He was gone, and I felt it, because all my life I already felt whatever other people would feel, and I didn't speak about it because it seemed to be unnatural. It seemed to be something crazy. It seemed to be something not allowed. And when he came back, I saw that he was relating differently. He was doing things differently. And I was wondering, and I didn't really get it. He tried to explain stuff to me about the box, and I was just sure. I didn't get it at all. And I almost let it slip. But like 5 months later, he said, you want to go, right? The next training is starting. And back then, I'm really thankful for my adaptive box, because I've been the good girl having no idea, just thinking, no, I don't think I want to go. Yes, I go. And so I went to my first ETB in Mallorca with Clinton and then Chloe, and it hit me. I had no idea what's about to happen. I didn't even read one sentence about anything. I had no clue what I'm getting into it. And I sat there, and it's like an arrow shoot inside of me. Finally, there were people who were feeling. Finally, there were people who talk about it even. And it's not sick. And I stood there, and I think it was just in the end of the training where I opened up to Aunt Chloe saying, you know, I can do this since I can remember, and suddenly the whole world makes sense. And she said, welcome. And from that day on, I have not stopped on my path to become a trainer, because what I realized, when I start holding space for people, something in my archetypal lineage opens up, and it brings me closer to what I want to do, what I am doing here, with how I can give my gifts is when I hold space. And this is why I'm holding space for Germany. Thank you.
Thank you, Sophie Madonna. Mr.
Hello.
Yes. Oh,
yes. Oh, hello from Miami. Mm-hmm. I am Jennifer Dominguez, and I am a possibility manager and trainer and coach, and I am in the health industry. I'm a homeopath. And some years ago, I was living in Seattle, Washington, and I had a very special woman living and working in my community, helping me raise my daughter and working with me. And her name was Annette Schuster. And she was working with me for some time. And I was in such low drama all the time. I was fighting with my husband. I was fighting with my neighbors. My life was falling apart. And I'm a healer. And every time that this woman showed up in my house, she had this grounded wisdom of an elder, and we would have a meal together, and it was so beautifully calm, and there was space to connect and speak. And I said, what is happening with this woman? I want what she has. And she never, in the beginning, when she started working with me, she never told me that she was a coach and bringing this work of PM into North America. She was new in the country. And at one point she started saying, look, you need some help here. And so I asked her to start coaching me. And at first she resisted and said no, because she was working for me and she said she was going to kick my ass. And so I begged her to please help me. And so I started working with her and I showed up for everything. I went to every ETB and every lab and did coaching with her. And it took me some years and I left Seattle and came to Miami, which is where I started. And I started holding spaces and brought these trainers from Seattle to Miami to hold space for my clients here. And through the years and over time, I just fell in love with this work and saw how I could bring it into my practice and really create transformation for my clients. And so I went to Europe and I took some trainings last year, about a year ago, with and Chloe and Clinton, and I was there with Vera and a whole bunch of trainers. And I thought I was coming to something called a trainer path gathering. I imagined we were going to be sitting around chatting and getting to know each other. And all of a sudden there I was in a lab. It took me about 2 days to realize, oh God, I'm in a lab. I didn't know. And that I still wasn't sure that I wanted to be a trainer at that time. And here it is a year later. And I started holding space for North America trainer path about a year ago. And that has evolved. And now we are on the tsunami tour, bringing Expand the Box and labs through Miami and Costa Rica and Mexico, and just watching this whole PM thing explode. And I love it. Yeah.
Thank you, Jennifer.
Thank you. Yeah.
Jesse, will you go next?
Yes. I'm Jesse. And I am the space holder for the Possibilitator Training Brazil. And about a year and a half ago, I found this work. It came to Florianopolis, where I'm living. And I did the Expand the Box training. And I thought, well, you know, I'll give it a shot, whatever. It sounds kind of weird. And I did it. And then I changed my whole life to do everything that I could to be at the next training that was coming up the week later. Like I rescheduled something, a training that I had to give. Like I just canceled everything because I said, it was like I had been working as a therapist, doing emotional healing body work for like the last 15 years. And there were certain things about the way I'd been working that were like, it was like, something's not here. Something's not working. Something's missing. What am I missing? And so I tried to develop this or that, or go to this training or that training to try and figure out what it was that wasn't happening, that wasn't clicking, that wasn't like fully complete about these processes that I was holding and witnessing and experiencing. And it would take me years. It took me 10 years to develop an idea, you know, that in the Expand the Box, after like 3 days, that idea was fully complete and just like fully alive and like buzzing inside me. And I had spent 10 years to try to figure that out. And here it was, like there was something here that I could experience in 3 days that gave me the same matrix that it took me so long to try and do on my own. And that kept happening over and over, one thing after another, that I felt like I'd been looking for to try and create a more integral body of or expression of work. And it kept like more and more until I'm full of those things. And then I'm overflowing with things that I can't even get. And I'm reaching for that, you know, new things that I'm just dangerous possibilities. And it's just exploding in all directions at this point. And I'm falling apart. And my world is falling apart because all the things that I thought I had figured out, I haven't figured out. And, or now I have to refigure out or unfigure out. That's what it is. I have to unfigure out everything I thought I'd figured out. And this happens now. I'm falling apart pretty much like every 2 weeks, you know, again, like the thing that I built, the little origami man that I folded myself into. It's like, oh, unfold it again. And, you know, and it's really, it's, and so it's like this necessity of, I'm here because of the necessity of becoming alive. And I didn't know I wasn't really alive. I mean, I spent so long, I spent 15 years doing body work that was all about being alive. And I didn't know I was numb the whole damn time. So it's, and that keeps happening, that re-unfolding again and again. And so to be a space holder for the Brazil path, for me is about, it's like, I waited when that question was asked. I was like, is anyone else going to raise their hand? Is anyone else going to raise their hand? And no one else did. And I was like, I will. And terror, fear. And I just held my hand up and I was like, oh my God, what have I done? And since then, it's what it's for me. And it's just recently that this happened. And for me, it's like, It's a deep, rich space of learning to be a space holder. Like there's no way you can learn faster. There's no way you can deepen and get deeper and richer and more alive other than being a space holder. Cause I've tried being a participant. And when I'm a participant, I kind of have the option of checking out all the time. When I'm a space holder, I can't do it. I can't check out so easy. And so it's like the honor of being in the deepest and richest learning space that I know. And that's why I wanna be here and I wanna hold this space for the Brazil team.
Thank you, Jesse. I also wanna call on Lee Kumar, who just sent me a message saying he was going to leave very soon. And Lee Kumar is one of the people who, in a group of the trainer training school, who go into the Possibilitator regional calls every 2 weeks to give extra food and extra practices to develop extra skill. And so I'd like Lee Kumar, if you could say a few words about, you know, your, why does it turn you on to do this?
You want me to speak, Vera? Really?
Yes.
Okay. My name is Lee Kumar. It's not my name. I'm one of the dinosaurs training 1999 at a consulting company in Germany. And I never got on.
Lee Kumar, could you turn off your camera maybe? The sound is not coming very well. Turn off your camera.
Okay, I'll do that. So how far did you hear me?
Nothing. Could you start again?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Okay. Good. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Good. I'm sitting in a car because I live in Paulden, Arizona, where we have no internet reception. I drive 30 minutes to the next town where I'm sitting outside in a car. The temperature is about 105 degrees Fahrenheit, which is related to 40 something Celsius. And I'm doing this on a regular basis because who I am is being a possibility manager. And I don't care what the outer circumstances are, because what required of me, what my life asks of me, is creating possibilities wherever I go, wherever I stand. I met Clinton 1999 at an Expand the Box training for the consulting company that I worked with in Germany. We did a lot of shit together. I'm still glad about it. And I'm feel more glad about what we're happening now, because when I left my series of expand the box trainings, of labs in 2003, I was asking the same question that Clinton was referring to the guy in Brazil. What am I going to do next? And then we created a few more experiential trainings, and then I moved to America, and then my life turned around a little bit. So that's all about me. I don't want to say too many words. If you want to contact me, please contact me. If you need possibilities, please contact me. If you hate me, please contact me. And if you love me, please contact me too. That's I. That's Lee Kumar. Thanks. And I'm leaving for my next call. I couldn't reschedule. I love you all. And please keep going. Keep going. And now don't allow any outer circumstances to stop yourself. Okay? Thanks a lot. Thank you, Vera. And Vera, you're my hero.
Thank you, Lee Kumar.
Thank you.
Like I said, Lee Kumar is part of a team of trainers that are in this trainer training school. So they're trainers to train other trainers to be trainers. And every 2 weeks, we have a rotation system where each trainer in the training school goes to one of these weekly calls and bring some extra food. And I'd like to also, this is going to happen in the Possibilitator training, and I'd like to hear from some of the people, from the people in the TTTS. And, so Chloe, will you go first? Thank you.
Yes. Vera, you're also my hero.
Thank you.
I don't know if I can say I met Possibility Management in 2017. I met Clinton. I got to live with Clinton for 3 months. And somebody today said to me, but how do you live with him? Like, isn't it like so intense all the time? And I said, anyway, what I thought was actually that I'm probably more intense than him, but people don't know that. So. And that my journey started. My journey started in 2017. And I was thrown into spaces, even holding space for the context of possibility management, even before my Expand the Box, my first Expand the Box that I did actually with Michaela and Mikael in Bielefeld in Germany. And it was really, I felt really glad to do an Expand the Box with other trainers and to realize, okay, this is not about Clinton. People can learn this and deliver this with such uniqueness and their own flavor. And it was just so amazing to be held by Michael and Michaela in Germany. And I mean, the journey goes on, and I have a lot of legends, and some of you have heard of them before. But what I wanted to say is, I discovered that when groups of people come together and commit to themselves and also commit to each other's growth and evolution, something different happens. And that was really, for me, the trainer path was a proof of that, of how we supported each other and held each other in really our deepest breakdown and breakthroughs. And to meet regularly, it was a real family that came alive and then grew really all over the world. But I've also had other experiences, like, for example, the Rage Club spaceholder training. We've held two with Vera, and now there's a global Telegram group with 45 Rage Club spaceholder. And to be in this group is so magical. Just Rania yesterday sent a message saying, I've held my first Rage Club and I'm just so alive. And everybody's really cheering ourselves on, yay and go, and like, go Finland, and the next country that comes alive was, first with anger, and then the next steps of this context. And so, yeah, I'm really glad to see you. I've seen a lot of you, some of you I don't know, and I'm just really glad to also meet new faces. And this is a welcome, like really welcome to the family, welcome to a tribe that if you let them will love you and you will love them back. And I just wanted to say something else that we're in terms of specialties, Clinton has mentioned some, and for example, with a group of people, so with Clinton and Vera and Sofia Magdalena, we are having this plan of going to Costa Rica and moving in with two older possibility management trainers to build a bridge house that would be this space where people can come and really bridge themselves between modern culture life and the pressure of the circumstances into sourcing next culture from their piece of the puzzle. And you know, we don't know how many, like what they are, and there's many pieces of the puzzle. And so one of the specialty also is maybe a bridge house space holder. Maybe you are a person who wants to hold space for this transition, for people to transition from modern culture to next culture. Mm-hmm. And just bringing that is, we need your unique flavor, your unique vision about next cultures. I would even add an S to what is possible and what can happen. So I'm, for this space to open, I'm just in awe of the possibility and really grateful to be with you guys here today, and hopefully for a very long conversation. Not today, but over the years.
Thank you, Aunt Chloe. Yes. Maciek, I would like to invite you to go next.
Thank you. So my name is Maciek. I'm currently in Poland. And we are figuring out a way to hold space also for the Polish region of the Possibilitator training. So there will be one, I think. And I'm in the trainer school. And now when you were telling stories about how you got into PM, I realized that I think I found my lineage or my job before I found PM. Somehow it brought me to this, because I used to be a neurophysics or neurophotonics professor and researcher at the university. And I realized that the best fun I have is when I create possibilities for young people. So my students were coming to me and they wanted to talk about life, not science. Mm-hmm. And somehow this was what was nurturing me. And also I was looking for community. I mean, the word community came somehow. So thank you, Vera, for bringing this back. And so I went to Finhorn for a day and I didn't find it. I just couldn't connect with Finhorn. And then ICO, the coincidence office, brought me to CEC near Berlin. And I went for a community building or a community workshop, and they were using possibility management maps. So there was a new map of feelings and low drama. And I don't remember much of the workshop, but I remember the maps. And I wanted to go straight to the source. I mean, where are you getting them from? So I booked the ETB and the lab with Clinton in a couple of months. And so when I heard about the Possibilitator training, I remember the moment when in the lab, it was my first lab with Clinton. And I don't know, Vera, if you remember, we are doing the diaphragm and the relationship space cleanout somewhere in the corner, my first lab, like second night. And my box, like the very intellectual, like a professor box, was trying to figure out, so which side am I creating the black hole on? And it's, should I close it or open? And it's like, poof. So I asked Clinton and he said, your name is magic, you'll figure it out. I said, okay. And something clicked in me and everything became possible. So it's like, whoa. So, and this is exactly what I mean, this is the best fun I have ever had in my life, being a possibility manager or possibilitator, whatever you call it. And then I went to another lab and I discovered that you can distill your bright principles. And it was so cool that I came back And I wanted, I organized a kind of, for friends, a workshop. So let's distill bright principles from the book and I can do it. And it was after two labs. And I asked the guy, the trainer who with whom I did the ETB, can I do it? It was Ralph. He's not doing this anymore. And he said, it's too much responsibility and wait a little bit. And I remembered Clinton saying, your name is magic, you'll figure it out. So I did it anyway. And it worked. And it was my very first workshop, and then first PM workshop in Poland. And Emilia was there, who is here. And also Marcin Schott, who is not here, but will be in the team. So they came and they said, where are you getting this from? And it was 3 years ago. And since then, suddenly we have the whole game world of PM in Poland. So yeah, you'll figure it out. It's thank you, Clinton.
Yes, thank you, Maciek. See, this, the Possibilitator training is about research too. You know, yeah. You are going to figure it out. You're going to develop this is to build the infrastructure that is required so that you discover for yourselves what is your speciality, what is the archetypal lineage, the your own unique way of holding space and for the upgrade of this, of the thoughtware of people. And how is that going to turn out? We don't know. So we're going to discover it together. Yeah. Clinton, do you want to, you are also part of the TTTS.
Yeah, I just want to speak more practically a little bit, just to reiterate or repeat the structure. You know, at this point, the groups of the Possibilitators, we're grouping by location. And in a way, at this point, it doesn't really make sense to group by location because we're meeting online. So there's flexibility in terms of where you find your home, you know, in terms of which of the groups you find home. And I think that pretty soon, in the not too distant future, the groupings, the clumps, as Vera said, the clumps of Possibilitators will come together around themes. It'll be a thematic grouping about what is your specialty, what is your specialty, and call in the kinds of trainings and develop the kind of skills, practicing those skills together. And I'm just really excited how this global space can grow now that we have a platform, a Possibilitator tribe around the world that can unleash so much potential. Because, you know, when we did not have that, or when I was focused down on just training trainers or something, it was so limiting. It was painfully limiting. And it took us a while to figure that out. So I'm just so happy that we finally have opened this space and broadened it out and can really expand our ability to help each other unfold what we all know needs to happen. We know that the next culture needs to emerge, and we are the ones doing it. And we're not the only ones, obviously. There's really millions of cultural creatives around the world. At the same time, I've spent decades visiting other teachings, other contexts, and I have not found what I really needed. And so I had to do the research with small groups of people to bring this into the world. And I just have not found it anywhere else. And so the thing is, everything we're doing is copy left. That means it's completely stealable. You can take everything from workshops, from books, from maps, from processes, from everything, and it's yours. It is open code thoughtware. And we want you to deliver enough Rage Club workshops and possibility coaching sessions and other workshops so that within a short time as possible, you can quit your corporate job and just do what you came here to do and really be a bridge person, be a facilitator of this shift to next culture. And it's been proven how easy, how straightforward that is to do. There's a bunch of people who've already been doing that. And I really hope it's all of you soon that you can actually spend your morning, day and night doing what you love to do. And so that's what I will be doing when I come into each of the regional or thematic possibilitator groups, is I will be just bringing the coolest skills and practice distinctions and new thought maps and deepening the context with everybody. And so we're all on the same page, kind of sharing what we've been discovering. And I look forward to this.
Thank you. Thank you, Clinton. And as a part of this structure, so I want to say that we have, we organize while we're still also online around the world, we also organize ourselves through a platform that's called Slack. So when more people come into the Possibilitator training, you will also be included in the Possibilitator training Slack, so that you can check who is around who, what are the researchers, what are the groups, what are the clubs being formed to work on that. And it will emerge, it really emerge with your questions and your interests. So for example, last year we had gremlin clubs to work out different ways of relating, like how can you relate with your gremlin in a completely different way? How can you empower your relationship to make it more conscious? There were rage clubs, there were decontamination clubs, the adult ego state decontamination clubs, the feminine, like the groups about women, taking a stand for women. What does it mean, women's culture in next culture? What about men's culture? And so this you will see, the groups that are there, and you can form your own groups and your research, because this is, if you want something to happen, this, you need to make it happen. It's your job to make it happen in the Possibilitator training and to create the team and to help that research that you really want to get chewing on. Basically, that's what the Possibilitator training is about. Go ahead, Clinton.
I'd just like to emphasize a certain point, which is that for years we've had possibility management and the name possibility manager. And it's simply a name for anybody who gets to know and uses and loves possibility management in their life, whatever. It's, they're a possibilitator. Excuse me, they're a possibility manager. And a possibilitator is this, is a commitment, as Vera said, a commitment to yourself to take this as a path. And one of the powerful distinctions that is a difference between somebody who's simply using possibility management from time to time or a possibilitator is this decontamination of the adult ego state. Because we did not know this 10 years ago, even 5 years ago. It's a recent discovery how often we as children mix in a child ego state or especially the gremlin ego state into our adult ego state as a defense strategy. And until you go through this year-long process or more of one behavior at a time, decontaminating your adult ego state from that, this will stay contaminated for the rest of your life. But we're designed for this to begin to happen when we're 18 years old. Not many of us are 18 years old in this call. So it's still possible to do. It is still important to do. It's still life-changing to do. I mean, I did not begin that part of even distinguishing what a gremlin was until I was over 50 years old. And now I'm only 53. And so I've still been working on it. So what I want to say is this is a real piece of work, this decontamination thing. It is it's a core piece of work, but it makes the distinction between somebody who's simply a possibility manager and somebody who's on the path of being a possibilitator. And that work will be in the conversation that we'll have together online and offline and in the trainings and in all the meetings we have. It's a central part of the work. And you, as strange as it seems, as difficult as it may seem at times, it does really work, and it is important to do, and it will give you a new connection with the entire way the world works. And so I wanted to put that on the table, because it's not a social group. This is not a Facebook group. It's not a fun time group, although it's immensely fun, as Metric was saying. But that's the purpose is the transformation part. The purpose is the path. And a path is an authentic path, which means that there are these liquid states. And the lovely part of this is the teamwork that we get to have here. And it's without the team, I could not ever have come anywhere on my path. So I'm so grateful that this is happening now. Thank you.
Vera, can I go ahead? Yeah.
I mean, I want to jump in on this train of the team and how even this morning I had a check-in call with Sophia Magdalena, and she said, God, I move forward and then I go around the next corner and then there's my next thing, like my next challenge, my next behavior, and I think this is true for all of us, like that we never get enlightened. It's not about enlightenment. It's not about getting perfect, or and in a way it's this, we look bad on this path of transformation. We look bad, and really one of the tendency that a lot of us have is, God, I can't be with people when I'm not okay. I can't be with people when I look bad. I can't be in the team. I can't ask for help. Many of us have these old decisions, and this is why we work in a team, and to really go through these emotional healing processes when these come up for you, and to that you can commit to your team somehow. There's that we can learn to really live in this next culture team, and that we've discovered some parts of it as we go along, and at the same time they get created by each of us commitment to ourself and to the team, and it makes a difference, and it makes a difference when you show up and you ask and you request, like you ask other people to show up. There's so many stories about in the trainer path with the Rage Club spaceholder about other people saying, hey, where are you? We're missing you. Where's your presence? What's going on for you? And the other person being in this isolation, like mixing fear and sadness, or being, I can't be on the team. I can't trust the village. And because there's this like necessity, there's this pull from the team, then the people can go through, you can go through these emotional healing process. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. And Chloe, it just reminds me of this legend from the region of Portugal very recently, where one of the men shared in the group how, so there were two men in the region of Portugal, and one calls the other and says, hey, what's going on with your presence? You're in the calls, but it seems like you're not really there. And what is going on? I miss you. And this is the person who receives the phone call. That's the one, that's the guy who shares. And he basically says that call saved my life. That call saved my life. I didn't even know that I was numbing, that I was avoiding being seen. And I was slowly, slowly moving away from presence, from transformation. And I'm so glad. It's just this, I miss you, this calling out, just totally enlivened that person's commitment and their connection. And so this is what it means to be in a team, that you are in a team, not just also for you, but you can also if you're in a team, you're also calling each other. I think it's time for some questions. If there's someone who has questions here about the Possibilitator training, this is the time.
When do we start?
Excellent question, Natalia. We start already next week. And we need to figure out exactly, you know, the groups. Like, if people come in, there's going to be it's going to take a little bit of time to see how many people can fit together, because more than 25 people in the same weekly call just simply doesn't work so well, because not everybody has a chance to share. And so we basically have this number, 25 people being a maximum people in a person, number of people in a weekly call. And so whenever this happens, that there's more people, another group will be formed. And so it could also even mean that some of you, without knowing, you might be the next space holders. You might be the next space holders for another clump, another group of people working together. So just, you know, if this calls out for you, pay attention to the signs. Yeah. After the call, the ones who are, okay, I am in. I'm in to come to a weekly call to work on this, on growing myself, on being an adult and taking a stand for in radical responsibility, then you know all the Possibilitator training website, and you register, or if you have already registered, to say I'm in, because some of you just registered for this call, and I would like you to think about it and to say I'm in. I am in.
So Vera, you're asking people to write you a message.
Yes.
On the Possibilitator training website.
Yes. Yeah. Saying I am in. And yes, because it tells you me where you are, and yeah, so saying where you are and what time zone you're in at the moment, and that you are committed, you're coming. Yeah. Any other questions?
A question. My name is Zoe. Sorry, I had to be off camera because I live out in the country and my service is very shady. So I'm just going to sneak on and hope this works. Is there a financial commitment?
To participate in the Possibilitator training, there's no financial commitment to get in. Now, if to work in your commitment to go to the Expand the Box trainings or the 10 labs, those, or go to a rage club or attend a rage club or participate in a fear club, those will require financial investment. And so it's investment in your own training. But to belong to the Possibilitator training, to be part of the Slack group and to be in the weekly calls, doesn't cost you money. Clinton, yes.
It's a surprising thing that one of the financial commitments that we ask of you is to be able to share your value in exchange for money, is to give what you really offer in your value as a value, what you are as a value, to receive money for that. And this is a huge process for most of us to be able to do, because we usually think time is money, and it doesn't work that way in next culture. Value is money. Value is value. It doesn't have anything to do. And so the thing is, each one of us has value and things we can offer to people who are trying to heal or trying to wake up or trying to get into next culture. You're already ahead of everybody on the planet. And so that is such a valuable thing. And we're asking you to become money. There's a website called Become Money, and it has processes on there, experiments to do, and it's a financial commitment for you to receive in exchange money, euros, dollars, whatever, for your value. And that's a huge breakthrough for many people. But it is a financial commitment to receive money.
Any other questions?
Yes. I feel my fear at speaking right now. My question is about how possible is it to change the time of this call every week if we are going to be here? Because I feel sad that I already have a commitment at this time. And it's something that I really love to do. And so I want to, and I am committed to this path. And I want to change the time of this meeting.
Yes. So this meeting that we have, the welcoming call, is an one-off. It's like maybe we'll do more welcome calls at some point. It's not like it's never going to happen again. But the weekly calls happen in the regions. And they, you know, this is why initially we had the regions, you know, the Germany, New Zealand, exactly because of the time zones. So each of the regions will agree on this, on a time that works for the people in those clumps. So this call is not going to repeat next week, for example. This is just the welcoming. Does that make sense for you?
Yes, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Kia ora, it's Jay here. I have a question. And I guess it might be unanswerable. What I understood about the trainer path was that it had a destination, in that it was heading towards people being able to hold space for ETBs and labs. And I'm curious because I wanted to be on that trainer path because I wanted to learn about holding space. I wanted to learn about being one of the ones who is holding space for the context of possibility management growing in New Zealand, where I live, and being part of that village. So there's been this distinction now so the trainer path is around training for trainers, ETBs and labs, and the possibilitator training is for, as far as I understand, holding space for the village, for the growth of it. And I guess I have just a curiosity, where is it going? What is it like, what is the distinction of the difference between a possibilitator and a possibility manager in their own life?
Thank you, Jay. So the possibilitator training is where you would work out the healing processes, the outside the formal trainings, like outside the labs, that you would work out how would you have enough of you, you know, out of the traumas and all the baggage, so that there's enough of you so that you can be your bright principles in action and can hold space, you know, can hold a radically responsible space, so that, you know, whatever then turns you on could be in organizations that you go and mediate or find new possibilities to evolve the game world into a Gaian game world. For example, go to a project or community or a business and you transform, you go in, and that's how you hold space in the context of radical responsibility. Or it could be that the thing that you learn how to do and that turns you on is doing emotional healing processes and possibility coaching or mediation. And you go into places where there's conflicts and you help people and you train people even in how to transform a conflict into connection. And the trainer path is actually one of the many specialities of the possibilitator training. And so the difference, like I'm going to put it back in the space, what Clinton said, that a possibility manager is anyone who would use the context, the tools, and who loves the distinctions of possibility management. And a possibilitator is basically, it's a space holder. of the context of radical responsibility. And how, you know, how you're gonna, how is that gonna affect actually, then we're gonna find out. There, we have some specialities already, but who knows what is going to needing to be emerging. Clinton.
Going first.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, you sort of answered the question. I was afraid that it was a feminine answer to a man's question. And that yes. It was like just a little too much. Answer is the trainer path is one of the specialties of the possibilitator training. And when you find your specialty in the possibilitator training, then you will meet with those people and you will train the skills for that. And so that's why now we have region, but probably, like Clinton said, it will merge into more theme, like specialties, specialty meeting. Yeah.
Like rage holder, spaceholder training.
Yes.
Yeah. So for example, there's a possibility mediator website that exists and it's waiting as a vacuum for people to own it and inhabit it. And there's nobody. Yeah, Julia Neumann is beginning in, but the entire world needs mediation facilitation that includes the distinctions of possibility management. And it's a whole world. And so I built the website because I know it will exist. Nobody is there yet. There's a possibility psychology website. Almost nobody is in there at all. There's a whole domain of psychology that's replacing all this Sigmund Freud, Carl Jung, understanding intellectual, psychological stuff from 200 years ago. It's outdated. There's whole new ways for dealing with psychology, mimetic engineering, and it's waiting to be inhabited. And these are just a couple, like there's a possibility acting website that's essentially empty. But, you know, these Michael Jackson, you know, all these performers who do not know how to navigate three worlds and heavy-duty sedate themselves with drugs because they don't know how to feel anger, sadness, fear, and joy, and to navigate the upper world, the middle world, and the underworld. So they just overdose and kill themselves and numb themselves out. What a loss. So there's a whole possibility acting section. Nobody's inhabiting that yet, but I built the website. It's ready for people to come and do that. So there's so much potential, and you know that's only 3 out of 1,000 new professions we don't even have names for yet. This is what you're asking about. It's like and only one is trainer, and so it's just because it just was an accident that we focused on that one first. But there's every single one of them needs to be inhabited and built and filled out. There will be 1,000 new websites, each one for one of these specialties, and you'll be having a welcome call into your specialty, whatever it is. I don't know what it will be. So like that.
Any other question, Tara?
I want to share something. And I want to share how glad I feel that this is happening, because this is exactly what I've been looking for. This is exactly what I've been looking for, because there has been this moment where I had an emotional healing process and I was supposed to ask my heart, like, what do I want to do? And I was asking, and then there was only the word, like, I wanted to spread what I got, and I wanted to live that, and I wanted to live what I can give. And then there was only this word of, like, trainer, and I only knew this, and I was like, but this is not that, somehow I cannot say that this is what I want to do, but I knew I wanted to go and spread and hold space and do this. And now I'm in a space where this is happening, and I feel so much joy about this. I feel like I'm exactly in the right place, and Echo is like working, and it's really great. So thank you. Yeah.
I'd like to say something, which is that for the first 15 years of possibility management, we kept it a secret. and we kept it a secret because we thought it was not developed enough. We thought it was too strange for people. We were afraid to let people know what we're doing. Well, in the last 10 years, that has changed. So many things have changed in the last 10 years. Even the last 5 years, so many things have changed. And doors are opening this way and that way. So please don't keep this a secret. Please tell people that this is available, that you represent it, that you're in it, that they can be in it, that they can be part of this, and that they can unfold this incredible potential that they've had since birth. Since their birth, we've been carrying this potential, and we've developed these ways to go out of the patriarchy and back into your treasure and let that grow. And that's what this is. We can help each other do that. So please don't keep it a secret. Please tell people.
Any more question?
I want the clarity if it's possible to join later, like we start in the whole group and we are not close, right?
So you can start whenever you want to start. So it's really your choice. And there's already groups. So there's already, you know, Joanna, Patricio, Sofia Magdalena, Julia, Jesse, and so there's already groups. And so that's where you would be added on. So the groups with the space holder, you would come in. And so it's really up to you when you want to come in. And but it's not in this big clump. Okay. This big clump of people, of 54 people and more, is only for the welcome call. Yeah? Did that answer your question?
Yes.
Super.
I'd like to say that this is it really takes something to be welcomed in. So this is not an open space. This is not a hippie drop-in joint. This is not anybody can come in and be friendly. There's really a context. And if you are not standing in that context, there's plenty of other places in the world for you to go do your thing. So there's a very clear context out of which Possibilitator emerges. And people who are not already generating that context are not really invited to come here. That's not what this is about. So the game world will protect itself, and because it needs to. It's special enough, it's rare enough, and it's clear enough to do that. So it will be protecting itself. I just wanted to say that. Thank you.
So I have a question just to clarify what Clinton said. So whoever wants to get in or get out should talk with you, Vera?
Yeah, the first thing is to send me a message that you want to get in, and then depending on like if you we'll have a conversation about it, basically we'll have a conversation and about the context, and then the next steps, where are the next steps for you to be in. Yeah, thank you.
Vera, you want us to reach out to you on that trainer website, right? That's where you want.
Yes, please.
Okay. Can you please put that on the chat, so because I know there's two.
Yeah, it's
in there already. It's the gameworldbuilder.mystrikingly.com. It's in
okay. There. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's the Possibilitator Training.
Yeah.
The Possibilitator Training.
It's the Possibilitator.
This last one that I just put in.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. Is there any absolutely burning question in the last 30 seconds of the official time? Anything else from anybody else?
Yeah, just a question. How will the groups be formed? It's just by region, or how does it work that the groups get into work or into action?
Well, right now there's regions because of the time zone. And like what Clinton said, eventually it will morph into the interests, the actual turns on of the people and their research. And until then, it's going to flow. It's going to evolve. So right now there's still regions, and we will see. I don't have a crystal ball to know how it's going to all happen. And I'm okay with that. Anything else?
Thank you, Vera, for taking a stand and holding space for this amazing game world.
Thank you.
Thank you for all the legends that were told.
Mm. Thank you. Yeah, thank you for all the space holders and trainers that just shared their commitment and their love. They love holding space so much that they're also willing to take this stand for people who are not even here on this call yet. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Vera.
Bye.
Thank you,
everyone.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
See you soon. Bye. See you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
Yes.